another Dodd-Frank G20 issue was initial margin. And you know, we've gone through the various stages. We're now coming up to the final stage. Do you think there's a solution that can be had?
Yeah. So first, Ken, I want to say this is something we're very sensitive to. And as I know you know, it was the CFTC that led the way in February of 2017 in the area of variation margin, and really led an effort to create a 6-month transition period. Policy remained the same, commitment to the ultimate outcome, but how do we look at process and how do we get there in a better way? So once again, we are now looking at the phase 5 margin implementation. And again, we've shown leadership because along with that is the study. There was also a CFTC study that you know came out a few months ago that looked at this and said this is worth further consideration. That as much as well over 1,000 new market participants may be drawn into this margin regime, and there is a question as to whether that poses real systemic risk if they are providing margin or not. And so we were very much engaged in this discussion along with ISDA and others, and we will show leadership on this issue as we did before. Again, what we at the BC, BS and IOSCO, the conversation is what's the process of continuing to monitor this and gather information and look at this? And we are very much in favor of the conversation right now about delaying the documentation period, which will help somewhat. But we don't want to foreclose a further conversation as to whether we actually need to look at the thresholds for average daily aggregate amount. And we're having those conversations. I think the conversations will continue probably throughout a good portion of this year. But we're very much open-minded to whether those thresholds need to be reconsidered. And as we formulate a view, we will share that with other regulators and where we can play a leadership role in this once again.
So you see with the BCBS IOSCO working group is other entities are coming along with the CFTC on this?
I think consensus is still to be formed. We will be at the center of those conversations. I can't foreclose. Well, I can't say where the final outcome is. What I'm determined right now is that all options remain on the table, including a relook at the thresholds, and not be foreclosed. That the documentation issue to me is a good start, but it's not the end of the conversation. I think the data still needs to be thoroughly reviewed, and people need to do some sense of where the real cost benefit value of bringing more firms into scope is. And that's a conversation that the CFTC will remain at the center.
Right. We appreciate the work you've done. We've obviously weighed in with you all, but also with with the other policy, the other regulators in the U.S. as well as around the globe and through the working group channel.